guys, it's Equineqt, and we gotta talk about some things tonight. They're really important. First off, I'd like to apologize for this. I know it's a soft-spoken, and I don't know how relaxing this is gonna be, because it's more of a vlog. And whatever that is, I don't really even know what that is. But this is more of a video that is just kind of a catch-up, and probably see more of my sparkling personality. So I apologize if this is not incredibly relaxing. I'm going to try and speak softly and slowly. I don't know, I might get excited telling you some of these things. The Christmas holiday was really, really busy, and it put a bit of a monkey wrench in my plans, so to say, for making videos. I know that a lot of people wanted to see a Christmas wrapping video, present wrapping video, excuse me, and a couple other ones that I had planned, and I've way overestimated my free time, which I ended up not having a lot of, and, excuse me, it's been raining in North Texas, like you would not believe. It's rain all the time, and then it's beautiful for like 2 or 3 days, and it'll dry out, and it's gorgeous, and then it rains again for another 3 days. So, my dogs have been pretty much cooped up in the house. Cooped up in the house. And so it's loud. And there's a lot going on. So it messed up my whole plans to do all my Christmas videos. And I'm gonna try and make that up to you guys throughout this new year. I don't have any resolutions other than to try and be more consistent with my uploads. Because I know you guys appreciate that, and I appreciate you guys, so. The other thing that I want to talk about is something that I discovered yesterday. Yeah, it was yesterday. I was looking back, I was looking for an ASMR video that I used to binge watch probably 3 or 4 times a day. Back when the ASMR community was still the whisper community, and it was a show and tell. It was an earring show and tell, and I cannot, for the life of me, oh my God, I can't remember the name of the ASMR artist that did this particular video, but I remember being obsessed with it. Just something about, I want to say she was, maybe her accent was Russian. It's been a long time. But, she had a lot of white noise in the background. I don't know what kind of camera or microphone she was using, but there was this perfect balance of white noise and, somebody's messaging me on my Facebook. There was a perfect balance of white noise and her clicky whisper along with her accent, and then just like the little like trinket sounds of her earrings. Oh, it was perfect. It was completely amazing. And I've been looking for that video for, so yesterday evening I was scrolling through thinking maybe I'll find it today, maybe today will be the day. It wasn't, but so I typed in, what did I type into my search bar? I typed in something like earring ASMR or ASMR earring like just keywords like that is what I was searching for. And you guys, I can't, I'm gonna have to try and keep a straight face when I talk to you guys about this. And I apologize in advance if anybody is offended by my reaction. I'm really sorry. I'm not trying to offend anybody, I swear. It's just the oddest thing that I ended up coming across. So, I was scrolling, and you know when you're looking for those, the old school ASMR videos, and you gotta pretty much scroll through like, you know, half of YouTube to find them? So, I was scrolling down, and I ended up coming across a video that made me do one of those faces, like, what did I just come across? I didn't even know what to think. And so, me being me, I clicked it. And I really wish I hadn't. So, the title of the video was, Intense. Was it intense or something? Intense ear eating. And I was like, what? So of course I clicked it. Because it said ASMR. I'm thinking, this is odd, but I gotta know. So I clicked it. And I'm like, the first like minute, nothing's happening. There's an ASMR artist in the background. And there's like a mic set up right in front of the camera, you can see it. And there's these little, like, plastic, they look like earmuffs, or like the, yeah, like earmuffs. And they have a silicone outline of an ear on the end of it. And I'm thinking, what is going on here? So you're like, okay, maybe she just has some kind of like odd microphone cover or something. So, again, nothing's really happening. She's just kind of making intense eye contact with the camera. And I said, okay, I got stuff to do. I got ASMR videos to find. I gotta know what's happening here. So I moved the little, what do you call that thing? The timer doohickey thing at the bottom of the screen. Anyway, I moved it over. This was like an hour long video, by the way. I was like, okay, if I just move it to the gotta be happening. So I moved it to the 20-minute mark and I hit play and it buffered for a second. And y'all, it, like, she was eating, like, mouthing the end of the microphone. And it left me going, watching. And I kind of sat there listening to it for about 10-15 seconds, and all it did was sound like someone was chewing in your ear, like right in your ear. And I paused it, and I was sitting there like, I didn't know what I just clicked on. And there's like a cult following, because I went back, like I clicked the back button to go back to the search list that I was originally on, and there are dozens of these videos of ear eating, ear licking, like really weird stuff. And like, they're popular videos. These videos have over 1 million views. And so the only thing I could think of was that maybe it's the equivalent of, like, people who like really intense chewing sounds. Like, people who, like, not me personally, but the people who, like, the chewy, sticky ASMR videos, where people eat raw honeycomb. And I can kind of see it. I get it a little bit. if you like that really sticky, clicky, like really intense sound, I kind of get it. But at the same time, I have a really big pet peeve of people chewing with their mouth open. It drives me insane. And so I kind of just want to, I can listen to it for about 10, 15 seconds. And then I really just want to slam my laptop down and make the sound stop. So I assume it's kind of like that. But I kind of get the ear, I get the ear thing. Kind of like I get the chewing sounds thing, because it's a very intense sound, and I mean, some people like to have their ears played with. It can be very euphoric for some people. I just thought it was really odd to have an hour-long video of someone making that sound, like they're sucking on your ear. It weirded me out, and I just needed to share that with you guys. Again, I don't mean to offend anybody. I really don't. Blew my mind. It was very odd. So, and so I was pretty much done looking for that whisper video that day. I'm like, nope, I'm out. That's enough ASMR for me today. Again, it's a new year here in Texas, as it is all over the world, and my work schedule is picking back up, and as I said, I work kind of odd hours, so it sets off my normal daily tasks get pushed back a lot, by like a couple hours, so sometimes it's hard for me to make videos at night. I have to wait till it's quiet, and that's usually around 9:30, 10 o'clock, which means I have to set up at 10 o'clock at night and record for an hour, hour and a half, and try and get it all done, and then I gotta edit it the next morning before I start work. So I'm trying to keep up, I promise. I've had a couple comments about, oh, we'd love to see your horses. More of the dogs. It's kind of hard to do that. My dogs are not quiet. Well, except Sophie. Sophie's sleeping over here. She's attached to me at the hip. The dogs are not quiet. The horses are not quiet. So I was thinking if you guys really wanted to see more of like the horses and the dogs, I mean, I guess you could make vlog videos about that, but I mean, I guess if you guys really wanted to see them all the time, you could follow my Instagram. I mean, there's not a whole lot on there, just kind of my, there's all like pretty much pictures of my horses, the dogs, sunsets. Every now and then there's a really cheesy selfie with some kind of snarky, sarcastic caption, because my personality, I'm a very nice person in general, but I have a very sarcastic personality to a fault sometimes. My mom used to, when I was like 15, I was getting in trouble for something that it wasn't anything major. I was a good kid, but she said something, and I remember I got smacked hard because she said something to me in the kitchen about something I'd done wrong, and I kind of like quit back at her real quick, and she turned around and went pop. And I've never forgotten that. So I don't think I smarted off again to my mom until I was like in my 20s, my early 20s, because I knew she wouldn't smack me anymore. I mean, if you guys want to follow me on Instagram, that's fine. Let me know. I'll send you my, or I'll, I guess I could put it in the comments of this video or something like that. Like I said, it's pretty much just pictures of my dogs and my horses and food, because I am a big foodie. I love food. It's amazing. That's another interesting thing that's happened since I've been in Texas. So, as most of you know, I am California, from California originally, and it's very good Mexican food in California. Very good Mexican food. It's very different in Texas. That's been the biggest thing to get used to, is that the Mexican food is not the same, and I know that all the native Texans, excuse me, get really annoyed when the Texas transplants, like myself, complain about the Mexican food. And I'd like, anybody who's from Texas that's watching this that's a native, I'm not complaining. It's good. It's just different. And it's a pretty significant difference. I had to make that adjustment too. And, but I mean, I like it here. Everybody is very nice. The pace is a lot slower here. Nobody's in a huge hurry. And, you know, you have people that are, of course, your average, you know, daily jerk or whatever, but everybody's very nice here, and I really appreciate that. They're genuinely good, wholesome human beings, at least that I've had the pleasure of encountering. And the kids here have manners. Yes ma'am, no ma'am, yes or no sir type thing. And it's been a great change, because, I mean, California now is not the California I grew up in. When I was a kid, you could play outside in the street. We'd play softball in the street with the neighbor kids till like 9:30 at night, you know? And now, you don't do that. Like, I don't even think kids play outside during the day anymore. But it's a big change moving out here, and I mean, it's been a bumpy ride. I'm kind of stumbling around a little bit still. I have a little problem with my sense of direction. In California, there are mountains everywhere. I grew up in the mountains. I grew up, you know, playing in the mountains, you know, vacationing, all that stuff. There's no mountains in Texas. It's flat. Maybe not as flat as Iowa or places like that, but it's pretty flat. So for the first 4 months I was out here, and honestly, sometimes still, if I'm in a new area of Texas, I'm pretty much got myself convinced that I'm driving around in a circle, because in California, if you're driving away from the mountains, you're going towards the coast. You're driving alongside them, you're going east or west. Driving towards them, you're usually going north. So I get out here and everybody goes, "Oh, it's easy to find your way around. Just look for the water towers." And I'm like, I am short. I can't see the water towers. See above the trees. But I've been getting used to it. It's, like I said, it takes time whenever you're moving someplace to get adjusted. I can pretty much get to and from the main cities that I need to get to, but that's it. If I go anywhere else, I need my GPS. And I feel bad, because I've never really needed a GPS in my life. But and the weather is different. Right now it is windy and cold. It was gorgeous today. It was 68 outside. Sun was out. It was beautiful. You know what the weather's going to be like tomorrow? It's supposed to be nice in the morning. And like, you know, in the 70s. And then by 4 o'clock they're predicting thunderstorms, intense rain, hail, and a possible tornado, I think, is what was on my weather app. And I'm like, what is happening? The weather's really intense. In California, we have a lot of earthquakes. Well, earthquakes. Out here, they don't have those. But when you're in California and you're asleep, and most native Californians don't panic when there's an earthquake. you'll hear it coming, you'll hear the rumble, and then you just kind of wait for it to, you wait till you feel the roll, and then you turn over and go back to sleep as long as nothing fell down in your house and your kids didn't wake up. When I first moved out here, there were some really intense thunderstorms that I've never heard thunder like this before, but it would wake me up because I would think, oh, it's the rumble before the earthquake. And so I'd wake up and I'd be laying in bed, kind of half awake, just waiting to hear the shaking to make sure nothing fell in the house. And then about after waiting for like 2 minutes, I'm going, oh, that's right, there's not an earthquake out here, it's just thunder. Turn over and go back to sleep. But it's been some interesting. You guys know I got another dog. Let's see if I can show you. Sophie. Oh, anyway, she's a rescue. Adopted her from the shelter just before Halloween. And I love her. She's a stage 5 clinger. Are you awake? Come here. Can I say hi? Say hi. This is Sophie. Can you say hi, Sophie? That's a good girl. She loves to hold hands. She's a big hand holder. Can you say hi? Can you say hi? She's a big hand holder. If you're not paying attention to her, she puts her paws on you just like this, and she waits until you hold her paw and tell her that she's pretty. Yeah, it's a good girl. She's about 3. The shelter didn't really know what her story was. She is missing half her tail, which you'll notice if you, like I said, if you end up following me on Instagram, you'll notice Sophie has half. Really sure how that happened. She has some trust issues. She has some trust issues. She is really weird about new people. She's just very standoffish, and you can tell she really wants to go meet the person, and she wags her tail. It's a nervous kind of a wag. She wants to. She can't really bring herself to do it yet. And we've talked to the vet who prescribed some anxiety medications for her that have actually been working really, really well. It's been helping her cope a lot better. She does a lot better now, just as a general rule. And she's finally starting to put on weight, which I attribute to the fact that she's not so anxious. And she gets along with my other dogs just fine. She loves my Labrador. Loves her. They're best friends. What are you doing? That's kind of it. There hasn't been... I mean, we're all unpacked now and just adjusting to life. I hear life... I mean, it changes all the time. This move has been one of the biggest life changes, I should say. I think the only thing that rivaled the move was probably my divorce. That was a major life change. But it's been good. My personal battles with my depression and my anxiety that I had mentioned in my video when I first came back, those are getting better. I mean, you still have bad days, but I hear you. Still have bad days, but they're less frequent and they don't last as long. It's been a very nice change of pace. I can cope a lot better. So it's always good. I pretty much rambled on for like minutes now, and I don't even think this was very relaxing, but I just wanted to make a video, let you guys know I'm still here, I'm still chugging along. Just been really busy, so I'm gonna get back on the video making train. To be honest, I just made a new wreath for my front door, and I was trying to make an ASMR video while I was making it, and it just, everything kept going wrong with it until I finally was like, you know what, I'm done. Took off my mic, turned off the camera, and just went to town and just had a relaxing time, excuse me, making the wreath, and I needed that, so, but, a lot of you ladies have been requesting that wedding planner roleplay, so I think that's going to be my next one, my next video. And I'm going to try and angle that more towards like an actual couple, not just the girls, but try to make it like a couple's interview, like ask questions that the bride would answer, ask questions that the groom would answer, so that I can kind of involve both men and women for it. And then I'd like to do some kid-themed videos, like kids' crafts and things, but I have to get down to the city, because we don't have a craft store, and my town is little. So I have to go to one of the bigger cities, and that's like a 25-30 minute drive, so I have to get over one of the bigger cities to get some of those kids' crafts and things. So, anyway, thank you guys for being patient with me, and I hope that you stick around, and I hope that you all have a blessed and safe 2019, and I will see you guys